hands up. We're going to be talking about the Bible verse, John 3:16. And we're going to sing, "For God so loved the world that he gave his what? Only begotten Son. Whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life." You guys got it. Let's sing it out.
Deep cries out.
I'm going to go to the left. What do we say? We're going to go to the left. That's right. So let's sing it out. Go to the left. We follow.
Here we go. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're going to jump, 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 jump in the river. Jump, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're going to dance, 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 dance in the river. Dance, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna jump, 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 jump in the river. Jump, 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 everybody.
One more time.
If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right.
We're gonna shout, 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 shout
in the river. Shout, 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 shout.
Let's go. We sing deep cries out to you, Lord. We hunger for your presence. We need you here now. Let's sing, friends, all together. Our hearts cry out for you, Jesus Christ. Are you guys ready? Let's do it. Here we go.
Deep cries out, deep cries out.
We're starting a new series, straight from one of the smallest books in the Bible. Let's talk about Jude. Get ready. Okay, the book of Jude. Wait. Okay. Found it. It's way at the back. Did you know that Jude is one of the shortest books in the Bible? They call it a letter. I like to think of it as a postcard. You want to hear something cool about Jude? He had a famous brother. Hey guys, you want to guess who it was?
George Washington?
Nope.
Julius Caesar?
Nope.
Was it Barbie?
That would be a sister. And no.
Was it Abraham Lincoln?
Nah.
Big Bird? Was it Elsa?
Again, a girl. Do you even know what a brother is? Hey guys, I'll just tell you. Jude was the little brother of Jesus.
Wow!
Isn't that cool? So why did Jude, the little brother of Jesus, write his little postcard? Memory verse. In the last days, some people will make fun of the truth. They will follow their own ungodly desires. Huh. The truth. Jude wrote this postcard to tell people the truth. Hey guys, wanna play true or false? We'll write statements on postcards, and you have to guess if it's true or false.
Mm-hmm.
You know how we know what's true or false? The Bible tells us what's true and false. And that's why we should read the Bible. Even the little postcard called Jude.
Happy Sunday, friends. It's Pastor Grace here. I hope that all of you had a wonderful week. It's been raining in Seattle, which is pretty exciting considering the hot summer that we had, right? I bet some of our friends are excited for fall to feel the crisp, cool breeze in the air, see all the changing colors of the tree leaves. But I also know that some of you are not so excited because that means that the cold is coming back. A lot of our friends have been getting sick, right? Isn't it amazing how our environment brings a lot of changes in the way that we think, dress, and do things? When our environment changes, naturally, you change too. I mean, how silly would it be if the weather outside is 40 degrees and yet you think it's summer, so you decide to wear shorts, sunglasses, and a dark tan? Pretty silly. Just like the weather, our circumstances and environments are constantly changing. It forces us to adapt to think in a certain way or do certain things. You know, change can be good, but what's even better than change is the unchanging love that God has for us through His Son, Jesus. If we're not careful, we can be so busy changing ourselves to the world's standards that we forget the truth of God. Last week, Pastor Sylvia talked about this unchanging truth. She told you guys that there is an eternal hope in Jesus Christ. This kind of hope, it lasts forever and it never changes. This kind of hope always leads us back to Jesus. The Bible speaks about this hope so that we can have faith in Jesus Christ, God's Son, and what He did on that cross. Jesus Christ died on the cross and rose again from the dead. Because of His death and resurrection, we as believers can always have unchanging hope. God kept His promise. And that's why we hope in this truth, that He will keep His promise when the Messiah returns. Friends, this morning I want to encourage you all to put on the full armor of God and stand your ground. Standing firm with the breastplate of righteousness and the helmet of salvation. When we stand firm in this gospel truth, our lives will change towards His righteousness. In today's Bible story, we're talking about a Christian brother named Jude. Jude wrote the book, you guessed it, Jude. Like the book of Philemon, Jude is a really short book in the Bible. Jude was one of Jesus' brothers, and at first, he didn't really believe that Jesus was the Messiah. Soon, when he saw that Jesus had risen from the dead, he realized that Jesus is in fact the Messiah, and he believed. Jude wrote a letter to the early Christian believers because he wanted them to understand the importance of the gospel. Certain people in the church were teaching false things. Jude told the believers that these false teachers misused God's grace as an excuse to continue to sin. Jude wrote his letter like this, "Dear friends, I really want to write to you about the salvation we share. But now I feel I should write and ask you to stand up for the faith. God's holy people were trusted with it once and for all. Certain people have secretly slipped in among you. Long ago, it was written that they would be judged. They are ungodly people, and they misuse the grace of our God as an excuse for their disgusting sins. They say no to Jesus Christ, who is our only Lord and King. Friends, Jude is warning us against these false prophets. We have to hate sin and stay away from it. Salvation is saying yes to God and no to sin. It's only through the salvation of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit that we can be fully free from our sin. As you all know, sin is anything that you think, say, or do that displeases God. That's right. But thanks be to God for Jesus, who gives us salvation. Because of Jesus, we can say yes to God and no to sin. In Jude's letter, he encourages the believers. He tells them to remember the truth, stand up for the truth, tell others about the truth. Friends, let's read today's main point together. Ready, begin. Jude encouraged Christians to stand strong in the faith. Just like sin leads us to think, say, and do things that displease God, salvation leads us to think, say, and do things that please Him. Just like sin leads us to think, say, and do things that displease God, salvation leads us to think, say, and do things that actually please Him. For believers, God's Spirit will always be there to guide you and help you. Jude writes again, "Remember what the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ said would happen. They told you in the last days, some people will make fun of the truth. They will follow their own ungodly desires. They are the people who separate you from one another. They do only what comes naturally, and they are not led by the Spirit. But you, dear friends, build yourselves up in your most holy faith. Let the Holy Spirit guide you and help you when you pray. By doing these things, remain in God's love as you wait. You are waiting for the mercy of our Lord Jesus to bring you to eternal life." Friends, this morning I want to encourage all of you that God is with you. He will help you to remember. He will guide you to stand up, and He will lead you to tell others about the gospel truth. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, thank you for reminding us today that you guide us and lead us. You are with us through your Holy Spirit. God, I pray that we can remember, that we can stand up, and that we can tell many other people about your gospel truth. God, your word never changes, and because of this, we have eternal hope. I pray that all of our Sunlight kids can remain in this hope until the day you come. Thank you, Jesus, for this wonderful worship time. We lift it up to you, and in Jesus' name I pray, amen. Friends, the truth of God never changes. Because it can never change, we have the confidence to stand firm in it. God knows exactly what you need and when you need it. So we don't have to worry about what you're going to wear if the weather changes or where to find the next pumpkin spice latte. God is unchanging and He loves you for all eternity. Let's recap today's message. Today's message comes from the book of Jude, verses 3 to 4 and verses 17 to 25. Jude is one of the shortest letters in the New Testament. Jude was written by one of Jesus' half-brothers, and in his letter, he warns believers about false prophets. He says that false prophets will try to encourage you to sin. But if we hate sin and choose to stay away from it, we too can have true salvation, and we can think, say, and do things that please Him. Jude reminds us and tells us to remember the truth, stand up for the truth, and tell others about the truth. I hope that all of you guys can remember, stand up, and boldly tell others about the gospel truth this week. Hope all of you guys have a wonderful week. See you next Sunday.